Reliance Commercial Finance presents India SME Forum 2012. Find out the secrets of success in a series of seminars exclusively for smart entrepreneurs. Join India's biggest SME initiative to boost your business and celebrate SME achievers with India SME 100 Award.
Not as a bunch of invisible people, but who you are. And if each one of you and your destinies are then linked with a brand, and the brand is then linked to the quality and the passion with which each one of you brings to the table, then we have a proposition. If you all remain in the way you are, in the next 10 years, you will not be, because China will overtake you. China will make better products, cheaper products, with much more technological input than India can afford to. And with the result that in the next 10 years, they will actually harbor us. So if we want to actually survive the next 10 years, which are very critical in everybody's destinies, because you've slogged and slaved and built your various companies from nothing. And also partly because at some stage in your life, you felt that you needed to be your own maliks and not knockers for somebody else or some other company. And therefore, you created products which were required and needed by not necessarily just by the aam janta or by public, but by other industries as well, which more so by other industries than by aam public. So as far as the public is concerned, you have no face. And I think somewhere along the line, that needs to change. That you need to be recognized by the association that you have with the product that you produce. And if you don't brand them, which is what branding as an exercise is, then believe me, in the next 10 years, and that is not a prediction, it's a promise, that you will not survive. Now, having said that, as a bad case scenario, what is a brand? Very few people actually understand the dynamics of a brand. A brand is a living, breathing, evolving human being. Because we always relate to brands at human values. We never relate to brands as inanimate objects like a glass. A glass is not a brand. A glass is a category. Within glasses, you have brands which have personalities. So when we give birth to a child, we nurse and give attention and give the child a name. And we hope that the child learns the business of right and wrong, courage and cowardice, intelligence and stupidity from us as parents. Because as parents, our job is not to leave them large amounts of money so that they can waste it. As parents, our job is actually to educate them in the business of right, wrong, reality, unreality, discipline, and vision, and passion. It sets them free, doesn't bind them. Similarly, your product is your child, your brand is your child. And most brands actually take on personalities of their owners. That's really, if you look at them very carefully, each brand that really is successful represents the owner of that brand and what he likes to be represented as. And the living things, you invest living time into them. And it is exactly like bringing up your child. Your child cannot remain 5 years old because he's cute for the rest of his life. He grows every year. And he grows a new set of personalities. But the basis of his existence never changes. So when you give your brief to your team and say, what are you selling? Who do you represent? You represent me, which is imbibed in this brand because I'm its parent. You represent this brand because what it represents in terms of what we feel it should represent, in terms of all the good things that societies have, not the bad things. So whatever we do, when we communicate the brand to outside people, the introduction of the brand is not a resume, it's a personality. Is he courageous? Is he cowardly? Is he strong? Is he weak? Is he sensitive? Does he write poetry? Is he passionate? Is he a great lover? Is he a great seducer? What exactly is he? And the brand can then be molded like we mold our children, not successfully all the time, unfortunately. But a brand is not as rebellious as a child is. So a brand can actually be molded into evolving. No brand remains the same. The brand has to mirror the society that it exists in. And societies today change faster than anything else. And therefore, the only thing that you should actually deal with is change, because that is the only constant. We have changed more as a society in this country in the last 10 years than we've done in the last 100. Just imagine, in 100 years, we haven't changed as much as we have in the last 10 years. And if your brands are not relevant to that new and brave new India, your brands will not survive. So your brands must always represent the best of the society today or anticipate the society tomorrow. It is not something that is made 50 years ago aur wo padha and roj puja karte hain usko, Gandhi ji jaise. They no longer become irrelevant. Between the government of this country and the Gandhi associations, brand Gandhi has now become relegated to one picture on the wall. He does not get involved in the day-to-day examples and functions of this country and its youth. We have killed him very effectively by not evolving him, by not making him into a living philosophy. That is exactly what your brand is. Brand Gandhi was a great brand. He was not an Indian brand, he was a worldwide brand. And just like brand Gandhi was a brand, so is what your product is supposed to be. A living extension of yourself. And so it might be a nut, it might be a bolt, it might be anything, but in it is invested a whole lifetime of work, labor, expertise, hopes, optimism, and passion. So it's not just a product which is objectified as a commodity. It cannot be. Are you a commodity? Each one of you is an individual human being that thinks and has expectations and aspirations and ambitions. So should your brand. Now, this panel here is going to take you through the process of actually how to build your brand into a living, relevant part of our society. And that if we don't do that, in terms of the collaboration that we do, today we have a huge R&D crunch. One of the biggest issues of actually keeping up with our neighbors, especially China, is that the kind of R&D that we spend, the money that we spend on R&D is minuscule compared to what they do, what the Americans do, what the Japanese do. My belief is that as a small-scale industrial sector, the largest small-scale industrial sector in the world, which is successful, is actually Japan. China is swiftly catching up. But Japan is looking to save its own small-scale sector, because they're now threatened, because they don't have raw materials. The Chinese have actually blocked them out. So what is our motto as a country? Our motto is, the enemy of my enemy is my friend. So who is the enemy of my enemy? It's Japan. And therefore, whether we like it or not, they are our friends. And whether you've explored it or not, the fact is that they're willing to share their technology. As a matter of fact, they've invested a hell of a lot of money in the corridor, the Bombay-Delhi corridor for industrial people, to move 20,000 of their small-scale sectors to find partners and mirrors in this country. This is a huge opportunity for you people to actually find a mirror partner in Japan and sit down and collaborate with them as far as technology is concerned, because they have the best technology in the world today. It's not going to last forever, because even technology has to evolve. But at least today, they're miles ahead of us. And they're just a little ahead of the Chinese. So if you're going to compete worldwide, and if you're going to compete with the Chinese, we have to get into bed with the Japanese in terms of the importance of the technology. There's a gentleman here who specializes in precisely that. Now, I'll give it over to Mr. Sinha from Lakshya. Lakshya is a media company which is going to help you rationalize the fact that because your turnovers are, you know, less than 50 crores or whatever, how do you then compete with the biggies in terms of building a brand? Because people think that brand building is a media exercise. Yes and no. How do you rationalize that? How do you take a 1 crore budget to build a brand and actually build a brand to that? What are the possibilities that you have? So I'll give it to Mr. Sinha.